हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल स्ट्रीम कॉमर्स। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच कॉस्ट कंट्रोल अकाउंट्स। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद क्वेश्चन नंबर 3। एज ऑन 31st March 2013, द फॉलोइंग बैलेंसेस एग्जिस्टेड इन शरद कंपनी लिमिटेड्स कॉस्ट लेजर। So in the first table, the balances are given for stores ledger, work in progress ledger, finished stock ledger, manufacturing overhead and cost ledger. During the next 3 months, the following items arose. So in the second table, the expenses are given which will be used to prepare ledger accounts. Show necessary control accounts and trial balance. So first let us start preparing journal entries. So the first expense is finished product at cost. Amount is given as 4,21,670. So the journal entry will be finished goods ledger control account debit to work in progress ledger control account. Amount will be 4,21,670 on the debit and on the credit side. Next is manufacturing overhead incurred. Amount is 1,83,020. So journal entry will be manufacturing overhead ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account. Amount will be 1,83,020 on the debit and on the credit side. Next, raw materials purchased. Amount is 2,46,000. So journal entry will be stores ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account. Amount will be 2,46,000 on the debit and on the credit side. Next is factory wages. Amount is 1,01,060. So the journal entry will be factory overheads ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account. Amount will be 1,01,060 on the debit and on the credit side. Next is indirect labor. Amount is 43,330. So journal entry will be work in progress ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account. Amount will be 43,330 on the debit and on the credit side. Next is cost of sales. Amount is given as 3,71,780. So journal entry will be cost ledger control account debit to cost of goods sold account. Amount will be 3,71,780 on the debit and on the credit side. Next is materials issued to production. Amount is given as 2,54,630. So journal entry will be work in progress ledger control account debit to stores ledger control account. Amount will be 2,54,630 on the debit and on the credit side. Next, sales return at cost. Amount is given as 10,760. So the journal entry is finished goods ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account. Amount will be 10,760 on the debit and on the credit side. Next, materials returned to suppliers. Amount will be 5,800. So journal entry will be cost ledger control account debit टू स्टोर्स लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट अमाउंट इज 5,800 ऑन द डेबिट एंड ऑन द क्रेडिट साइड. नेक्स्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ओवरहेड चार्ज टू प्रोडक्शन अमाउंट इज 1,54,400. सो द जर्नल एंट्री विल बी वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट डेबिट टू मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ओवरहेड लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट अमाउंट विल बी 1,54,400 ऑन द डेबिट एंड ऑन द क्रेडिट साइड. सो अकाउंट्स टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन विल बी फर्स्ट कॉस्ट लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट और जनरल लेजर एडजस्टमेंट अकाउंट. सेकेंड स्टोर्स लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट. थर्ड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ओवरहेड लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट. फोर्थ वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट. फिफ्थ फिनिश गुड्स लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट. सिक्स्थ कॉस्ट ऑफ सेल्स अकाउंट. सो फर्स्ट लेट अस स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग द बैलेंसेस अमाउंट. सो फर्स्ट इज गिवन एज स्टोर्स लेजर कंट्रोल अकाउंट अमाउंट इज 6,02,870. So we'll record it in stores ledger control account on the debit side. To balance brought down amount is 6,02,870. Next work in progress ledger control account balance amount is given as 2,44,730. So we'll write it in work in progress ledger control account on the debit side. To balance brought down amount is 2,44,730. Next finished stock ledger control account amount is given as 5,03,890. So we'll record it in finished goods ledger control account on the debit side. To balance brought down amount is 5,03,890. Next, manufacturing overheads control account amount is given on the credit side, which is 21,050. So we'll record it in manufacturing overhead ledger control account on the credit side. By balance brought down, amount is 21,050. Next, cost ledger control account amount is given as 13,30,440. So we'll record it in cost ledger control account on the credit side. By balance brought down, amount is 13,30,440. Now let us start recording the expenses. So first expense is given as finished product at cost amount is 4,21,670. So the journal entry we had recorded as finished goods ledger control account debit to work in progress ledger control account amount is 4,21,670. So the first effect will give in finished goods ledger control account as to work in progress ledger control account amount is 4,21,670. And now the second effect will give in work in progress ledger control account as by finished goods ledger control account amount will be 4,21,670. Next is manufacturing overheads incurred. Amount is 1,83,020. So journal entry we had recorded as manufacturing overhead ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account amount is 1,83,020. So the first effect will give in manufacturing overhead ledger control account as to cost ledger control account amount is 1,83,020. Now the second effect will give in cost ledger control account as By manufacturing overhead ledger control account, amount is 1,83,020. Next is raw materials purchased, amount is 2,46,000. So the journal entry we had recorded as stores ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account, amount is 2,46,000. So the first effect will give in stores ledger control account as to cost ledger control account, amount is 2,46,000. And the second effect will give in cost ledger control account as by stores ledger control account, amount will be 2,46,000. Next is factory wages, amount is 1,01,060. So the journal entry we had recorded as work in progress ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account, amount is 1,01,060. So the first effect will give in work in progress ledger control account as to cost ledger control account, amount will be 1,01,060. Now the second effect will give in cost ledger control account as by manufacturing overhead ledger control account, amount will be 1,01,060. Next is indirect labor, amount is 43,330. So the journal entry we had recorded as manufacturing overhead ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account, amount is 43,330. So the first effect will give in manufacturing overhead ledger control account as to cost ledger control account, amount will be 43,330. And now the second effect will give in cost ledger control account as by overhead ledger control account, amount will be 43,330. Next is cost of sales, amount is 3,71,780. So the journal entry we had recorded as cost ledger control account debit to cost of goods sold, amount is 3,71,780. So the first effect will give in cost ledger control account as to cost of sales account, amount will be 3,71,780. Now the second effect will give in cost of goods sold account, amount is 3,71,780. So by cost ledger control account, amount is 3,71,780. Next is material issued to production, amount is given as 2,54,630. So the journal entry we had recorded as work in progress ledger control account debit to stores ledger control account, amount is 2,54,630. So the first effect will give in work in progress ledger control account as to stores ledger control account, amount will be 2,54,630. Now the second effect will give in stores ledger control account as by work in progress ledger control account, amount will be 2,54,630. Next is sales return at cost, amount is 10,760. So the journal entry we had recorded as finished goods ledger control account debit to cost ledger control account, amount is 10,760. So the first effect will give in finished goods ledger control account as to cost ledger control account, amount will be 10,760. Now next effect will give in cost ledger control account as by finished goods ledger control account, amount will be 10,760. Next is materials returned to suppliers amount is 5,800. So the journal entry we had recorded as cost ledger control account debit to stores ledger control account amount is 5,800. So the first effect will give in cost ledger control account as to stores ledger control account amount is 5,800. Next, the second effect will give in stores ledger control account as by cost ledger control account amount will be 5,800. Last, manufacturing overhead charge to production amount is 1,54,400. So the journal entry we had recorded as work in progress ledger control account debit to manufacturing overhead ledger control account amount is 1,54,400. So the first effect will give in work in progress ledger control account as to manufacturing overhead ledger control account amount is 1,54,400. Next, the second effect will give in manufacturing overhead ledger control account as by work in progress ledger control account amount will be 1,54,400. So now let us take the total of cost ledger control account. So the total amount will be 19,14,610 on the debit and on the credit side. Now let us take the balance which is coming on the debit side. By balance carried down, amount will be 15,37,030. So now in stores ledger control account, let us take the total of both the side. So the total amount is 8,48,870 on the debit and on the credit side. So the balancing amount is coming on the credit side by balance carried down. So the amount is 5,88,440. Next, in manufacturing overhead ledger control account, let us take the total of both the side. So the amount is 2,26,350 on the debit and on the credit side. In work in progress ledger control account, let us take the total. So the total amount is 7,54,820 on the debit and on the credit side. And the balancing amount is coming on the credit side by balance carried down, amount will be 3,33,150. The balancing amount of cost of sales account which is coming on the debit side will be transferred to finished goods, that is finished stock ledger control account, so which will be termed as sales. So the amount will be 3,71,780 and the total amount will be 3,71,780 on the debit and on the credit side. So this amount will be transferred to finished goods ledger control account by cost of sales account, amount will be 3,71,780. So now let us take the total of finished goods ledger control account, that is 9,36,320 on the debit and on the credit side. And the balancing amount is coming on the credit side by balance carried down, amount is 5,64,540. Now let us prepare trial balance as on 31st March 2013. So in stores ledger control account, the balancing amount is coming on the credit side, which is 5,88,440. So we'll record it in trial balance. Stores ledger control account amount is 5,88,440, which will be on the debit side. Now in manufacturing overhead ledger control account, the balancing amount is coming on the credit side, which is 50,900. So we'll record it in trial balance. Manufacturing overhead ledger control account amount will be 50,900 on the debit side. Now in work in progress ledger control account, the balancing amount is coming on the credit side, which is 3,33,150. So we'll record it in trial balance. Work in progress ledger control account amount will be 3,33,150. Now in finished goods ledger control account, the balancing amount is coming on the credit side, which is 5,64,540. So we'll record it in trial balance. Finished goods ledger control account amount will be 5,64,540. Now in cost ledger control account, the balancing amount is coming on the debit side, which is 15,37,030. So we'll record it in trial balance. Cost ledger control account amount will come on the credit side, which is 15,37,030. So now let us take the total. So the total amount will be 15,37,030 on the debit as well as on the credit side. Thanks for watching. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And if you need more sums on this topic, then kindly let me know in the comment section.